Hi and welcome back to This Bytes For You. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install the Sapphire Radeon NITRO RX 6700 XT OC card. I'm going to show you not only how to install the physical card, I'm going to show you how to prepare your system for the card, and then what to do when the card's already in there. So let's get started. All right, so to get started on the system, the first thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to go to wagnerdsoft.com. And we're going to want to download the latest version of DDU. Now, I always recommend to download DDU to strip the machine of the older drivers so that we can prepare it for the newer drivers. And then since this is an AMD card, we're going to go ahead and download the drivers from AMD. Not from Sapphire, not from anybody else, AMD. Okay, submit. And download the latest and the greatest. And always read the release notes to find out all the gotchas and everything in case there's an issue, known issues. This will definitely help you out tons. But anyway, now that we've gotten that out of the way, we're gonna go ahead and extract DDU. So double click on that. And we'll put that on the root of the machine. I'll call it DDU1 extract. So now in order to get that to work, we'll hold the left shift key, right click the start button, hover over shutdown or sign out, and click restart. This is to allow us to go into safe mode. So now on this screen, you can let go of the left shift key now. You'll click troubleshoot, advanced options, startup settings, and then click restart. All right, so after a few seconds, you'll be at the startup settings screen. We'll go ahead and hit 4 to enable safe mode. Okay, so now that we're in safe mode, we'll go into File Explorer, this PC, and then wherever we extracted DDU to, and then we'll run this one. So very important to pay attention here. If you have an AMD card and an AMD chipset, pay close attention. It doesn't mess up too much if you have an Intel chipset or any other chipset. It's just the AMD that could potentially cause issues. So in my case, in this machine, we have an AMD X570 chipset. So AMD specific options, it's going to remove everything here. I'm going to uncheck all of that. Then make sure down here where it says prevent downloads of drivers from Windows updates, make sure there's a check here. You can go ahead and remove everything here and kind of keep everything as it is here. You may have to resize the window. Okay, now you'll click here under select device type. You'll select GPU. Now, if you're coming from NVIDIA, AMD, or Intel, I recommend DDU for all of them. This particular machine has an NVIDIA card, so I'm going to select it. If you have Intel on die graphics, select Intel. If you're coming from an older AMD video card to a newer AMD video card, select AMD. If you're coming from NVIDIA to AMD or whatever, select NVIDIA. Okay, and so now since we're going to go ahead and remove the video card to pop in the new video card, we're going to go ahead and select clean and shutdown. While that's doing its thing, the reason I always recommend to use DDU, even if you're going from AMD to AMD or NVIDIA to NVIDIA, is it gets rid of all the old drivers, preparing your system for the new drivers. That way you don't have any kind of glitchy side effects from older drivers that just don't uninstall from AMD's or NVIDIA's uninstaller. It sometimes just can't uninstall itself correctly. So you'll find random directories in random places, files, registry edits, entries. It happens all the time. DDU is a third party that gets rid of all the stuff NVIDIA, AMD, and Intel leave behind. That's why it's incredibly important, and it gets updated often. Now, if you're going to be working inside of the machine like we're going to, and you don't have a grounding strap, I never use a grounding strap. After you disconnect every single cable, plug back in the power cable. And flick it off. That way you stay grounded and you don't have the potential when you're plugging something in, it gets grounded and everything turns back on. It's a good way of losing all your stuff. Of course, when you're done and you want to use it, make sure to turn back on. If not, you're going to forget and you're going to be frustrated for a while. All right, so now that we have the system powered off, we have the cable connected and the power supply flipped off, we're going to go ahead and remove the old video card. First off, we're going to want to remove the PCIe connections. Now, on most NVIDIA cards, the clip is on the bottom, and on most AMD cards, the clip is on the top. So I'm not going to show you on this NVIDIA card how to remove it, but I will show you on the AMD card since it's a lot easier to show you. So for now, we're just going to unplug these guys. And thankfully, they're going to be the same connections we need for the 6700. This is my old EVGA Geforce RTX 2080. Now we're going to go ahead and remove the screws from over here. Now I'm using a new camera with new lighting and everything. So let me know what you guys think. Is it too dark? Is it too bright? Okay, and now you can't just pull the card off. If you do, you're gonna end up breaking your system. You're going to have to press on a little clip back here to release the card. Let me zoom in so I can show you how to do that. All right, so zooming in just above the video card, you're going to notice a little clip right here. Now, it might look different on your motherboard, or it could even be on the bottom side of the card, but chances are there's going to be a clip there. So what we're going to end up doing is either with our fingertips, if we can reach it, we're going to push that in, and I'm not going to hold the card, but you're going to notice the card is going to slide out just a little bit. It clicked out just a little bit. That click lets you know that the card is released. Sometimes it'll slip back up. Now you can just pull the card out and the card comes out super easy. I'm going to pop it back in and then show you from further away how that looks like. Notice that little clip, it's going to pop back up in a second. Notice how that went back up and clicked in place. So now zooming you out, push this in, releasing the card. And now card comes out very easily. Now, with that being said, you're going to want to make sure over here you have enough PCIe slots opened up so that you can fit this card in. This card only requires two on the back. Even though they say 2.5, you don't need a third one down here. So I have three open, so more than enough space there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and line that up and just push it in. And that goes ahead and clicks that again over here. Let me show you a different angle so you get a better idea. Okay, so I'm going to take the card out again. Okay, now notice this slot right over here. That's where this is going to fit in. These two little pegs right here, they're going to slide in to two little pegs right over here. You'll notice one here and one here. So when you slide the card in, you're going to pay attention to the pegs over here on the left, and then those fingers right up here, and then make sure that locks into place. So now with that locked into place, we'll go ahead and screw the video card in. Now this is a long card, almost 5 inches, and it sticks out very far over here. So it could be a little difficult to get your screwdriver in there. So just be careful of that. All right, so now after having screwed in the video card, let's go ahead and connect the PCIe connections. So if you remember, I mentioned before, the clips are on the top for AMD cards and on the bottom for NVIDIA cards. Again, not for all cards, but for most of the cards. So kind of a distance view, just slide that in there and it clicks into place. But let me show you from a different angle so you understand what I mean about clipping into place and unclipping when you need to remove it. Okay, now from the top angle, we'll notice there's a little bar right over here, and if we push down here, that bar goes up. That's relieving or removing itself from that clip. So pull that, push that down, and then pull the cable out. If you don't release this clip from here, if you end up pulling this out, chances are you're going to damage that. Now, let me show you this from a different angle from over here. That way, it's a lot easier to understand. Okay, now coming at it from a different angle, again, we can see that little clip right there, or that piece of plastic, and then there's this clip right over here. You notice up and down releasing itself. I just align the PCIe correctly and slide that in. You're gonna notice that black piece of plastic goes over that lighter piece of plastic and locks into place. To remove it, easy enough, right? All right, so now that the card is installed, let's go ahead and install the drivers and get working on this. All right, now that you're back in Windows, you're gonna get all these pop-ups because chances are you didn't plug in everything in the right spot. Don't worry, not everybody does. I mean, the USB connections, you have 35,000 devices and you know what I mean. Anyway, so now that we're back in Windows, we're going to go ahead where we downloaded the latest drivers. So they're right here, 21.4.1. Let's go ahead, double click on those. We downloaded the drivers from AMD.com. We're not installing them off of Windows download. You don't ever want to install video drivers, especially off of Windows download or Windows updates. You want to download them from NVIDIA.com or AMD.com. They make the drivers, they make the GPU. It's kind of their thing. Okay, so then we'll go ahead, place it at the default location or wherever you want those files to be and click install. Right, so now this is going to be kind of like DDU, but a second pass for to make sure everything is good. Additional options, factory reset options. Now, you don't have to do the factory reset option. Every single thing I'm showing you to do is to make it better, to make less potential issues show up. If you don't mind issues, go ahead, just install however you like. Don't even watch the video. My two cents. But anyway, let's get back to that. All right, and now install. This is going to go ahead and restart the computer, kind of like we did with DDU before. And now that you're in a clean state of Windows after the reboot, it's going to go ahead and install the drivers. So what we just did was it uninstalled everything, restarted in a safe mode, took care of a few other things, and then now still in that safe mode of a fresh restart of Windows, it's now installing everything. All right, so now that it's done, I always uncheck this and I always restart. Anytime you install a driver and it asks you to restart, go ahead and restart. All right, now that we're back in Windows after a fresh install, to do a little optimizing, mind you, this isn't going to be the entire package, but to do a little optimizing, you would just right click on your desktop, you go to display settings, quick way to do it, advanced display settings, and you're going to want to make sure here that your refresh rate is as high as your monitor can get. So AMD likes to put it at 59.9 something or other. My monitor can do 120. So my system, everything is going to be much smoother at 120 hertz. Mind you, if your system can only do 60, it can only do 60, or if it can do 240, just put it as high as you can. Okay, so coming out of here, that was just one thing. Okay, so we're on the 21.4.1, the latest driver. So we are using the record portion right now of record and stream. So I don't want to mess this up, but depending on your video chipset, the 5000 series and above, you'll have the record and stream. Then under home, you know, we have all the games that we have. We can launch the game, screenshots, instant GIF, the recent games we've played, the driver version, check for updates, our current recording session under gaming. Here we can make a bunch of changes to the games we have installed to make them run better, to, you know, compatibility over here. Here it tells us everything we have is going to work well. Oddly enough, this is not available, but anyway. I've already shown you record and streaming. This is off of the desktop. Here is off of live streaming. I'm not recording live streaming, but because since I am recording here, scene editor, media, performance. Now here's where you're going to get a lot of your performance. They show your metrics here, which is great. You could turn it on, turn it off, and then the overlay over here. Under tuning, click I accept. Then here is where you can do some overclocking. You can do automatic or presets. I myself recommend manual. Then you would just turn all this stuff on and you can manually overclock. Of course, please do be careful here. I've been thinking about making an overclocking guide. Do me a favor, like the video and let me know down below that you want an overclocking guide. And then, you know, I'll work on something along those lines. You can apply your changes here. The cool thing about these newer drivers, they have a stress test so that you can test to see how good your overclock is. Recommendation, if you're overclocking, make sure everything is 100% stable on your stock settings. Test it with 10 gains. Test it a bunch of different settings. If it crashes once, anytime, once, it's not stable until you test every single game. Then you can overclock once it's stable. Okay, advisor, this is going to go over some of the different default settings, profiles and all that good stuff. And then global statistics over here. Anti-lag, chill, boost, definitely enable those. Radeon enhanced sync, check the driver release notes. It causes issues with a few games. Wait for vertical sync. I always turn it off. You know, you may have a different preference there, but then a bunch of different stuff there. So display, if you have FreeSync, enable it. My particular monitor has FreeSync. When I test it with it off because not everybody has FreeSync and I want to do my testing for everybody. All right. And then overrides over here for HDCP support and custom resolutions over here, color deficiency, which is great for people with different sorts of color blindness, and just a bunch of different options here. But I wanted to go over some of the basics on the performance and everything. All right, so I've just shown you how to install the physical card, removing your old drivers, and pop in the brand new Sapphire Radeon Nitro RX 6700 OC graphics card. And you know, I've shown you how to remove, install, and then install the drivers, and then how to do a little optimization. Mind you, you could do a lot more, but this will get you going for all your latest games and everything. Hopefully I've helped you out. So go ahead, leave down in the comments if you have any questions, comments, or concerns. As always, please do click like and subscribe. It helps me out so much. And also, if you want to buy me a coffee, go right ahead. I'd love it. Thank you so much for your support. And again, any questions, comments, or concerns, leave them down below. I have links to everything in my system, including the card and everything, down in the description below, in case you're curious. And you know, I answer all my questions, comments, and concerns. So go ahead and leave them down below as well. This is your friend Iggy with This Bites For You, just showing you guys how to install the Sapphire Radeon Nitro RX 6700 XT OC. Iggy out. See you guys.